Hello and welcome back to Ixo Dental Dialogue, the webinar. Welcome back after summer vacation. I hope you had some good time. Europe is still coming to grips with the new COVID-19 reality. I think fortunately many dentists are back to work and we all have learned how to deal with the new high intensive disinfection measures, preventive and proactive. But I think we are now good to go, to be honest. We all have learned how to work with it. In previous webinars, we have also been discussing the financial implication of the corona crisis, including recommendation of cost savings and increased efficiencies. But in today's webinar, we will focus on clinic design and architecture. We will talk about how intelligent clinic design can assist the dentist to excel. It's about efficiency and cost savings, occupational health, but not at least about aesthetics and making the patients feel at ease. Among our community of dentists working with Ixo units, we have visited dentist Kimmo Kastorf in southern Denmark and talked to him about his collaboration with our Ixo premium sales partner Nordenta. We shall hear about their architecture collaboration, design thinking and lean principles being instrumental in achieving an outstanding architecture result. Now, let me introduce dentist Kimmo Kastorf, a Danish dentist with a strong and persistent vision of redesigning his clinic after so-called lean principles. Let's have a look.
Hello, and welcome to the health center Kostein. My name is Kimmo Kastorf, and I'm a dentist for the past 30 years, as clinic owner the past 25 years. And we are located in the most southern part of Denmark, close to the border to Germany, in a little town, Kostein. I had the opportunity to join a health center together with a doctor and physiologist in Kostein. It was a crucial part for me that we had some lean principles in designing the clinic. And that's why I placed the chair in the operatory room in that way that the patient has easy access to the chair. They don't have to run around it. They go directly from the door opening into the chair. And the drawers and the cabinets are designed in that way that the lean principles is a central part in designing this operatory room, because using rubber dam almost for everything, I have the drawer here, which contains every instrument belonging to the rubber dam. And I'm specialized in endodontics, so I got the company Inform to customize a cabinet for me so I have every part of my endodontic treatment instruments inside here, and I can close it while working with other treatments in the office. We got also the tray system. So the most common instruments we use for the examination we got in a tray system located here. Very easy access. The sterilization room is centrally placed, so it can be easily accessed from all treatment rooms. That ensures efficiency. So I use a microscope, and I mounted a video camera on the microscope, so the patient has the same view as I through the microscope on the monitors on the ceiling and on the wall. So they always will have the opportunity to see the same, exactly the same as I do. It's very modern to talk about minimal invasive dentistry. And with the use of the microscope, you're able to treat minimal invasive. And most of the patients, they will feel very confident in the treatment while having the same view of the treatment on the monitor, knowing that we work and treat absolutely minimal invasive. Already 10 years ago, I bought my first XO46, and in this new health center, I had to invest in some new units, and of course, I decided to buy some XO units from XOCAM. And the main reason why I bought XO is that the past 25 years I joined the International Dental Show in Cologne, and every single time I passed a unit, it's named Kevo, Siemens, some Chinese units, I always take the instrument and feel how it lays in my hand, if there will be any pullback or some tension in the instrument. Otherwise, it will give me some uncomfort in the treatment. I need an instrument, a unit which allows me to work with any stress from the working part, and I call my little unit as a little workhorse, because it's never gives up. It's working without any problems from the morning to the evening. As I told you, I had a XO46, which I bought 10 years ago. I didn't have any complaints about the efficiency of the unit, and I'm very, very satisfied with the unit, and it gives me joy in my working day from the morning to the evening.
Well, that was great feedback from Kimmo. Thank you so much. I think it was really interesting to hear that he has moved his own clinic into a medical center now, and that he's working or following the guidelines of lean management. And I think that is something very interesting to find out, that design thinking is not always about shapes and colors and something like that, but it's more about the efficiency, or to create a more efficient working environment. I've got a definition here by Jim Warmack and Daniel Jones. The lean methodology is a way of optimizing the people, the resources, the effort and energy of your organization towards creating value for the customer. It is based on two guiding tenets: continuous improvement and respect for people. I mean, there's nothing to add. This will bring me to our next section. We had a chance to interview Jens Petersen, who's the sales director of Nordenta in Denmark, about clinic design. Let's have a look what Jens is explaining to us.
Goddag, mit navn er Jens Petersen. Jeg er salgschef her i Dansk Nordenta, og har været her i en overrække, 30 for ikke det løgn, og har i alle de år solgt henholdsvis XO og Flex-udstyr rigtig meget. Nordenta er en af XO's premium-forhandlere, og det er vi i kraft af, at vi har vores showroom både i Glostrup og i Hørning, syd for Aarhus, med udstyr fra XO. I Nordenta har vi en stor serviceafdeling, hvor det er, at med 25 mand, som servicerer alle vores kunder fra Skagen i nord og ned til Gedser i syd. Teknikerne er fordelt rundt om i landet, bor centralt, og er selvfølgelig meget også centreret rundt om store byerne. I kraft af, at vi er premium forhandler af XO-produkter, jamen, så sørger vi jo selvfølgelig for, at de her teknikere altid er veluddannede og kan alle de ting, vi skal. Vi har også en stor interesse i at indrette nogle fine klinikker til tandlægerne rundt omkring, som gør, at de kan få en fornuftig hverdag og ergonomisk hverdag. Og i disse tider opfylder alle krav, der nu er til nier og alle andre infektionskrav, der er. Covid-19 her har givet os udfordringer også, og det vil sige, at klinikkerne i dag, den måde vi indretter dem på, ser lidt anderledes ud, end vi gjorde bare for 3-5 år siden. Når vi skal i gang med indretningsopgave for en tandklinik et eller andet sted i Danmark, jamen, så er det jo vigtigt, at vi tager en dialog med kunden først for at finde ud af, hvad deres planer. Er det bare to nye skabe inde på klinikken? Er det et helt nyt klinikrum? Eller er det et helt nyt klinikhus, der de skal lave? Så der tager vi en lang dialog med kunden om, hvad for nogle forventninger lignende de har. Vi forsøger jo altid at vejlede kunden så godt som muligt om, hvordan at denne klinik skal se ud. Igen tage udgangspunkt i de krav, der er til klinikker og omkring hygiejne og lignende. En af de klinikker, vi lige har haft fat i her inden for det sidste års tid, det er Kimi Karstorff i Gråsten. Og Kimmo, han er jo rigtig god, fordi han har jo haft nogle rigtige interesser i, hvordan hans klinik kan se ud. Så der har vi været en bindeled imellem ham og leverandørerne af inventar og håndværker og lignende. På inventarsiden der bruger vi inventar fra Danish Healthcare Design. Det kan være, at der er flere, der kender det som Klimo og Inform. Og det er jo noget, vi har solgt igennem mere end 30 år, så vi har rigtig god erfaring med deres produkter. Når det er, at vi skal indrette den her klinik, så er det jo rigtig, rigtig vigtigt, at alle håndværkere sørger for at få at vide, hvor det er, at installationer skal komme op. Det er jo vigtigt, at tandunitten står rigtigt i forhold til inventaret, man har i kl. 12 position bag patienten. Så det er, at klinikassistent og tandlæge kan nå de ting, de skal nå på bordpladen eller i en utræksplade eller lignende. Og derfor så, for det er, at det bliver rent økonomisk, jamen, så skal de her ting passe sammen. Så man kan sige, at tandlægestolens nakkestøtte er meget, meget vigtig i forhold til, hvor inventaret står. Derfor så, når vi laver sådan en oplæg til en indretning, jamen, så sørger vi selvfølgelig for, at alle installationer bliver indtegnet på tegningen og lignende, så det er, at håndværkerne ved nøjagtigt, hvor tingene skal være. Det skal være sådan, så den dag, at vores servicetekniker kommer med den nye XO-unit, altså passer alle installationer, så man bare sætter den ned på gulvet og skruer den fast, og så virker det hele. I den case med Kimmo Karstoff fra Gråsten, så var han, har han ikke været meget i tvivl om, at det var XO-units, han ville have igen. Og det er fordi, han har haft en lang års erfaring med at arbejde med XO, og en af de ting, han fremhæver igen, det er, at instrumentophængets balance. Og der har han prøvet adskillige andre units, hvor der er, han ikke på nogen units kunne finde en balanceophæng, der var lige så opbalanceret, som der på en XO-units. Så det var en af de store årsager til, at han valgte XO igen. Hvis der er nogen af jer tilhører, der har blevet inspireret af det, jeg har hørt i dag, så er jo meget velkommen til at kontakte Nodenta, og så skal vi være med til at lave en rigtig, rigtig flot klinik til jer også, med et fantastisk udstyr fra XO.
Well, thank you, Jens. That was great feedback from your side, and thank you for Nodenta in participating. I hope you have been inspired by this case of intelligent clinic design, but as we are about to end this webinar, I'd like to raise a flag. I'm sure that you have all noticed that many dental events and conferences around the world have been cancelled due to these new situations and to COVID-19. And usually we see those events as meeting points for us to catch up with all of you, with our partners, with the dentists around the world, with all our communities. So as this has to change, we really like to stay connected with you on any digital way. So I hope that we can follow the guidelines of webinars and digital meetings and everything like that. But I would actually sincerely invite you to send me a short text already today, maybe. What is your thought? What is your idea? What are your comments? To let me know about what we need to, or what we like to talk to you about on next webinars, or what we can create. What is the topic you are interested in, or what is it what you have been missing maybe on a webinar and you like to hear next time? Which is a guest you like us to invite to a webinar and have a chat about a certain topic? We would really appreciate your effort. Please send me a short text, please comment below, or send us an email to info@ixo-care.com, and we like to be connected with you. So that brings me already really to the end. So thank you for participating in today's webinar. Thank you for all the participants in the webinar, and I would like to see you again in September. See you then. Bye.